the next final, which is the men's C 1000 meters, the canoe 1000 meters. C1 1000 meters, David Carl goes here actually, the world record holder and the Olympic record holder. First of all, of course, we'll have the B final as we did in the K1 1000 meters, and in this Richard Jefferies goes for Great Britain, but again, this is not an event which he really wants to be featuring in. Britain, as the host nation, did have a place and they had to fill it, so Richard Jefferies goes here, but a young man who's perhaps better in the 200 meters and better years to come. In lane one, Alexander Djatchuk goes for Kazakhstan, and Diat Gray for Senegal in lane two. Cristobal for Mexico in lane four in this B final.
1 minute to start, gentlemen. 1 minute.
Peter Coletta initially failed to qualify for this game, so he was later included as a replacement in the Polish team for the injured Pavel Baraszkiewicz. Josef Cirilla. He looks really impressive in his round one heat, but then faded in the semi final. Fortunato Passavira from Angola had a bit of a struggle yesterday in his races, and I think will again today, as did Richard Jefferies. Just having a chat with Fortunato Passavira, 25-year-old from Bembridge in the Isle of Wight. Still gets the role that all great British athletes do in this Olympic Games.
Gentlemen, please approach the line. Please bring your boats down to the line.
So they get ready to get into position. Again, this is just to settle the positions from ninth down. Let's see the supporters come out. Fans of Josef Cirilla here. I think, along with Peter Coletta, perhaps the...
Please approach the line, gentlemen. Bring your boats into the docks.
Shining brightly now, it really is warming up as well. We're told the temperature is rising towards the end of the week, and we'll have all the sprints there, the 200 meter races which are in the Olympics for the first time. But here, the men's C1 1000 meters B final, Kazakhstan, Senegal,
ready,
Australia, Mexico,
set,
and
there of excellent technique, just falling on that blade, driving the paddle into the water. They want to make sure it's fully buried before they actually pull on it, to make sure they get the maximum reach and maximum power through the water.
So up to the 250 meter mark, it is Josef Cirilla and Peter Coletta, as we expected. There's two big guns in here taking the head of the Cristobal of Mexico. Everybody, Richard Jeffries, being left somewhere behind. Of Cirilla, and these three are beginning to separate themselves from the rest.
It really is a challenge of core strength as they hold their bodies in such a position high up in the boat. They really drive through that front foot, and the back leg is knelt in a foam block and they shape to make sure that it fits and they get the connection through the boat. It's a key in this canoe sprint, is a connection from your lower body all the way through to the upper body and then into the water.
Josef Cirilla beginning to go backwards a little bit, and perhaps more importantly is that Peter Coletta is moving forward, moving strongly, and now he's competing in the C1 200 metres later on as well. And he leads through the halfway mark from Cirilla, and Jose Cristobal of Mexico. And look at the distance between these three and the rest. These three will be taking 9th, 10th and 11th in this event. And Richard Jefferies is not in the last place, that dubious honour goes to Fortunato. has been getting huge cheers, Paseveros. He comes through last in every race over the line. But as much as what the Olympic Games is about, as much as those contesting the higher places. And the higher places in this race at the moment being filled by Peter Coletta and by Jose Cristobal of Mexico and by Josep Chirilla. Coletta now moving up to length in front.
Great shot to demonstrate how the athlete is controlled through that pull in the middle and really forward the blade, snaking their bodies forward, which gets the bow of the boat to jump ahead. Coletta looking strong at the moment.
Still out in front, and in fact just opening the half a metre of water between himself and Jose Cristobal and then Josep Chirilla. And Coletta there, we go and see the dip and the fraction and the twist. Jose Cristobal beginning to close, perhaps just getting almost an overlap. Although as we look down to the hill, you can see that's probably not quite the case. Coletta still keeping Cristobal at a distance, and again, tremendous noise from the stands to the left-hand side, and still Coletta. As Cristobal tries to close, and think he is closing just a little bit now. Does he have time to come back as they come into the final 100 metres now? Coletta still from Jose Cristobal, and don't think he's going to be caught, and these three should finish in this position for 9th, 10th and 11th in this event. It is Peter Coletta as they come into the final 50. Jose Cristobal really charging and trying to get on level terms, but I think he knows that Coletta has him here. Peter Coletta comes through to take victory in this B final from Jose Cristobal of Mexico and then Josep Chirilla, and then a long way behind all the rest, and all the rest at the moment being led by Jake Donaghy, the young Australian. And Donaghy now will get a cheer as he comes through. Peter Coletta is utterly spent after his effort there, but the 17-year-old Queenslander Donaghy eases through now. And then a race for the minor places, and Richard Jeffers is labouring to the finish now. He didn't really want to be in this race. And Jack Gray from Senegal comes through. And then Fortunato Passavera from Angola gets his customary roar, and Richard Jeffers will get something as well as he comes across the line. And he will hope for better in the 200 metres. And also hope for better in Rio. That was really his target in 4 years' time. As Alexander Djachuk, who is a sprinter, who went off to a flyer and then raced the rest of the way hand wave, comes across with a wave. But Peter Coletta, the winner of this B final, and a fine race with Jose Cristobal and Josep Chirilla.
So, our official results of this B final: Coletta from Poland, Cristobal from Mexico, Chirilla from Romania, Donaghy from Madrid, Massavilla, Jeffries, and Yachok. In that order, our ranks.
This canoe discipline, extremely difficult. Even the balance in the boat. And this aerial shot really shows how they have to use their whole body, and that connection from the feet, the foot in the front through the hips, and that snaking movement to use the drive through the hips to get the blade into the water nice and deep.
Confirmation then of the way they finish in this B final. Coletta out in front ahead of Jose Cristobal and Josep Chirilla. These to settle 9th, 10th, 11th and down positions in this event in the B final. And we prepare for the main event, the A final, to settle the medals. Vadim Menkov goes for Uzbekistan. Ilya Stokolov for Russia in lane 2.
In 5, bring your boat up with the rest, please. 2 and 5, bring your boats up with the rest.
Well, the canoe symbol, the C1, 1,000 metre final, and a roar from Mark Oldershaw, who is introduced.
Down the line.
A very, very talented canoe. David Kahl, the world record holder, the Olympic record holder. Alexander Zhukovsky of Belarus, competing in his 3rd Olympic Games, 5th in Beijing. 4th in the World Championship in Hungary last year. But here, look out for Attila Vajda from Hungary, lane 3, for Mathieu Goubel of France, in four. Sebastian Brendel, European champion the last 3 years, is in lane five. And Mark Aldershaw from the Aldershaw dynasty. His grandfather paddled in the 1948 games. He was coached by his father, who paddled for Canada and Los Angeles, native for his uncles as well. In lane six, now you see the way they angle their boats at the start here, depending on which side they paddle on. Make sure they're not losing any impetus with steering at the start. Off they go in 5 minutes. Simon, 1,000 metres off the surge again, lifting that rate high, and eventually they drop down to a rhythm. And Stokolov goes off quickly, as does Mathieu Goubel. And Goubel and Sebastian Brendel looking strong, but Aldershaw as well alongside Brendel. At the moment, it is Goubel and Brendel who take it out, with Vadim Menkov from Uzbekistan up at the top of your picture also going well.
And we'll see the pace now drop slightly as they find their rhythm in the middle part of the race. Timing almost identical at the moment between Goubel and Brendel. As they're neck and neck in the first part, driving their bodies forward, getting that connection, getting the water moving past their boats.
So there's Vadim Menkov and Sebastian Brendel and Mathieu Goubel, who are the first three through there as they go through the quarter way mark. 250 metres gone, 750 to go for the gold medals in this men's C1, 1,000 metres.
Menkov now on the outside in lane one, really looking like he's taking it out hard, but he is renowned for doing this, and sometimes it can go disastrously wrong and blow up towards the end.
Again, a great look from Erhard, the technique here in the canoe discipline, the C1, 1,000 metres. It is a brutal, a hard event. It takes its toll on the body, very, very one-sided, and a tremendous balance from these athletes, as well as tremendous power. Still it is Menkov in lane one from Uzbekistan, came fourth in Beijing, and his form over the last 18 months suggests that Olympic medals are a real possibility. World Cup this year, he's had two silver medals, and here he leads again as they go through the halfway mark just from Sebastian Brendel and Mathieu Goubel. These three still clear of the rest.
And with every stroke we see that there is the boat just jumping forward, digging in deep now. The hips start to burn as they have to really get that rhythm going, keep it smooth, making sure there's no rock on the boat.
And now it is Brendel beginning to make a little bit of move. He's up level with Vadim Menkov. Brendel, the European champion for the last 3 years, 24-year-old police officer from Schwedt-Oder up in the northeast border of Germany. Level with Menkov just about as they come up to the stands on the left-hand side. Again, the coaches cycling along on the left-hand side, trying to shout orders. These athletes will not hear them. All they will hear is that wall of noise which meets them now, and it's Brendel and it's Menkov, but it is Sebastian Brendel looking stronger, timing his run well. The battle for the first three, and also moving well now. Mark Aldershaw beginning to make a move from Canada in lane six. Can he get into contention?
And Aldershaw really does pick up towards the end of the race, as he did in the heats in the semi-final. He really wanted to get out there, but Brendel is leading this race dominantly at the moment.
And we look down at his determination on his face. Brendel looking good for the gold medal, opening it up now. Vadim Menkov hanging on grimly to the silver medal position, but he's being challenged by Mathieu Goubel, and also now latterly by Mark Aldershaw at the bottom of your picture now. But also David Carl is making a late charge up on Aldershaw. Time and distance may be running out for him, but Brendel, the gold medal, is calling him home. Sebastian Brendel coming up into the final 50, 60 metres perhaps. David Carl, what a move he's making in lane 7, the Spaniard. And Sebastian Brendel looks to be fading. What a fast finish from David Carl. He's coming up surely to take the silver medal. Aldershaw is there as well, but Sebastian Brendel holds on for gold. David Carl comes through to take the silver, and Mark Aldershaw for the bronze. And Vadim Menkov, despite all his efforts, was raced out of it and into fourth. Sebastian Brendel takes the gold though, and he is utterly spent, but he has a gold. And David Carl, well, I wonder if he just came a little bit too late. He gave everything he had. He was so fast finishing there, came through to take silver, and Aldershaw the bronze.
Well, David Carl picking up with every stroke he did over that last 250. There's our winner, Sebastian Brendel from Germany.
He has the gold medal. I have to say as well that the silver medal for David Kahl makes him Spain's most successful Olympian of all time in terms of number of medals won. He now has 5. He was the Olympic champion in 2004. This is the Olympic champion in 2012. Sebastian Brendel. He was beginning to tire, no doubt about that. And Kahl coming through to take it from Aldershot for the silver medal. And Mark Aldershot getting the bronze. And there is the technique, the effort put in by Sebastian Brendel. And Germany have the gold medal. And he has the celebrations.
Led the race from start to almost start to finish with a bit of a push from Menkoff in the middle section, but David Kahl from Spain and Mark Aldershot from Canada really gave him a challenge towards the end. There just was not enough water.
Well, there we are, Sebastian Brendel. He is the gold medalist, and confirmation of that result in the A final. Gold medal to Sebastian Brendel of Germany, Spain's David Kahl. Figueroa taking the silver with that finishing spurt. Mark Aldershot of Canada, the bronze. Those are the medals. That is the A final. In the B final,